Hello everyone, myself Prashant Tyagi from team Lexus & Company. Today in this video I am going to discuss about the legal dimensions of media. This topic, legal dimensions of media, directly relates to the media and criminal law. So to understand the legal dimensions of media, we have to discuss about the media and criminal law. So we start our video. While the Constitution provides a guarantee to freedom of speech and expression, which is exercised by the media, the criminal law imposes certain restrictions on the freedom for protecting the social or group interest and public tranquility. Article 19, subsection 2 provides certain grounds based on which the state can impose reasonable restrictions on this freedom. Media persons are basically under the same obligation as the people in general to abide by general principles of Indian Penal Code. Media in its exercise of free criticism may slip either intentionally or through its routine activity into any kind of criminal liability under the different circumstances. The Indian Penal Code investigates certain crimes which a media person may get entangled into and face prosecution. The right to free speech of media persons cannot extend to cause sedition by bringing disrepute of the state or affect the reputation of individual leading to defamation or represent absence or base of material disturbing the moral and serene atmosphere of society. In case they do so, the criminal provisions of Indian Penal Code are affected. Thus, the defamation, sedition, obscenity are the three major areas which the media persons could be vulnerable to face the prosecution. The first and important point is media and crime of defamation. Journalist who defames is liable both in civil and criminal law. Section 499 of Indian Penal Code defines defamation. Whoever by words either spoken or intended or by read or by signs or by visual representation makes or republish any imputation concerning any person intending to harm or knowingly to having reasons to believe that such person is said except in certain cases hereinafter expected to defame that person. Intention to harm. According to section 499 of IPC, the person who defames another have done it intending to harm, knowing or having reasonable to believe that such imputation will harm the reputation. It is not necessary to prove that the complaint actually suffered directly or indirectly from the scandalous imputation alleged. It is sufficient to show that the accused intended to knew or had reason to believe that the imputation made by him would harm the reputation of the complainant, irrespective of whether the harm is actually caused or not. It is not necessary that there should be an intention to harm reputation. It is sufficient if there was a reason to believe that the imputation made would harm the reputation of complainant under section 49 of Indian Penal Code gives in this regard. Second, media and crime of sedition. Criticism of government is not sedition. The expression sedition generally means defamation of state, but the legal meaning of sedition is different. Section 124A of the Indian Penal Code defines the punishment and the sedition. Whoever by words, either spoken or written or by signs or by visible representation or otherwise brings or attempts to bring into hatred or contempt or excites or attempts to excite defection towards the government establishment by law in India shall be punishment with imprisonment of life, which may fine may be added, or imprisonment which may extend to 3 years, to fine both. To understand the media and the sedition, I am going to discuss three explanations which defines the meaning. The first expression. The expression disaffection includes disloyalty and all feelings of enemy. सेकंड एक्सप्लेनेशन, कमेंट्स एक्सप्रेसिंग डिसअप्रोबिएशन ऑफ मेजर्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट विद अ व्यू टू ऑब्टेन देयर अल्टरेशन बाय लॉ मींस विदाउट एक्साइटिंग और अटेम्प्टिंग टू एक्साइट हेटर्ड कंटेम्प्ट डिसअफेक्शन डू नॉट कंस्टिट्यूट एन ऑफेंस अंडर दिस सेक्शन. एक्सप्लेनेशन थ्री, कमेंट्स एक्सप्रेसिंग डिसअप्रोबिएशन ऑफ द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव और अदर एक्शन ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट विदाउट एक्साइटिंग और अटेम्प्टिंग टू एक्साइट hatred, contempt or disaffection does not commit offense. Another and the final is media and crime of obscenity. The society is now reeling under the impact of unintended flow of cinema, story, dance, drama through small screen of television and of pornography in its vulgar form in personal computer with world wide web. The television with powerful multi-channel visual splendors is totally occupying the young minds. Its utility in educating, informing and news giving is complicated by its misuse in dishing out obscene and indecent stuff in the name of entertainment. Images of women in electronic media either by way of commercial advertisement or themes or serials or repeated show of films can straight away the influence of young minds. It is the need of civilized world to protect the human dignity, and the media form of any kind has to project the image of humanity in decent form. The commodification of women as the object of sex and obscene written or visual or sensational theme of a serial film depends on the moral and cultural levels of the society. While other media have their own limitations of reach, the TV and the internet have no technological, territorial and literacy limited. The writing is for those who know to read and write, and the film is such is meant for which they have to pay. TV at present is playing a role of medium of medium by becoming a vehicle for films based on stories and novels. A song and dance part of a fight sequence is having a tremendous impact because of its repetition in TV, the most powerful and effective vehicle of thoughts at present. These all points that I defines directly relates to media in its criminal liability. I hope you guys understand the meaning of media and the criminal liability. Thank you so much. Stay safe, stay tuned, have a nice day.